Dissect DJs in the building. Steezy, DJ Jack, let's get it. Come on.
Right now, he's probably slow dancing with a bleach blonde tramp, and she's probably getting thirsty. Right now, he's probably buying her some fruity little drink, cause she can't shoot whiskey. Right now, he's probably up behind her with a blue stick, showing her how to shoot a combo. And he don't know.
Stop it right there. What's going on, everybody? You know who it is. We already announced it. DJ Jack, Casteezy. What's going on, Steve?
It is the DJs that like to split it, mix it, play it back, and dissect it. And we finally got a country jam for y'all. Y'all country
heads.
Well,
we had one
there
before. Devil Went Down to Georgia, but not
That's
really
right.
Country. It's more of a classic top 40. Everybody knows this song. So we did a real country song.
Yeah.
And the reason we did this one, there's a reason behind it, right?
Right. So this is a follow-up to our previous episode when we did Shaggy's It Wasn't Me. And after getting
in which Rick Ross was
Rick
cheating with the next-door neighbor
Ross
all over the fucking place.
Rick Rock.
Yeah, Rick Rock. He was on the shower. He was on the bedroom floor. He was on the counter.
And homegirl just watched
and
it
she
all
just watched the whole thing. So what we realized was like, hold up. Is Carrie Underwood the girl that decided to torture herself and watch the entire thing and get it on video camera?
She brought her camcorder out for that. No, but we were just saying, I'm surprised there's no backlash song, like the song that's like from her perspective. So that got us thinking, maybe this Carrie Underwood song,
is it
Before He Cheats, is a response. Let's just go ahead in our little dissect DJ
world.
Be like, okay, this is the response to Rick Rock, because she had plenty of reason to be upset with all the bullshit that Rick Rock with his goddamn
neighbor. They never
mentioned
it. They never mentioned it. All they said is, and she caught me on the counter, and she caught me on, and so she just kept catching him and stuff. But they never say what she did, and I believe that this is what she did. What you're gonna hear in this song is what happened. Now we've already started the song, and she's talking about right now. You're probably doing what was it? What was she saying?
She says he's probably slow dancing with a bleached blonde tramp, and she's probably getting frisky.
Hating on whoever he's with now, understandably, because he was just banging everybody.
I like how that she's immediately building her own like bitch that she wants to hate on.
Beach blonde tramp.
Yeah. She's just letting all of her insecurities just slide all over the place. Right now, he's probably buying her some fruity little drink because she can't shoot a whiskey.
Stop right there. I gotta be honest. If I could be the girl that's shooting whiskey, not making a face afterwards, just let's party, I'm afraid of you. I'd much rather buy a fruity drink and see where that goes than the girl that's going to drink a whiskey shot, sit there and be
slurp
like,
slurp it down.
Yeah, and be like,
she's like, fuck the shot glass. Can you just give me the whole bottle? Fuck, pound this bitch.
I'm not messing with that girl. The whiskey straight drinker, she's going to get not just crazy later, aggressive.
And again, she is letting all her insecurities come out because she's like, I'm thinking that whenever Carrie's at a bar, she's looking at any girl that has bleach blonde hair, any girl who's drinking a fruity little drink, and she's just like, this fucking bitch over here, which can't even shoot whiskey, I bet.
Fucking sex on the beach, can't even do a fucking
hoe. Which makers. Actually, let's be honest, these are the kind of thoughts I think that probably dance around certain girls' heads a lot when they're out.
Well, especially if she caught her man banging on the...
Well, yeah, so now she has all this pent-up hate that she's just spewing out there when she's walking out there in the scene. And this isn't even there. This is all in her imagination. Then she follows it up with, right now, he's probably up behind her with a pool stick showing her how to shoot a combo. Which it's like, is this how he got you? Because that sounds like a very specific backstory that you're describing there. That like, you know, he does know how to shoot that pool cue real well. And he did teach me how to hit a combo.
That's exactly how he got her. That's exactly why she's saying that. Because that's how she remembers their first date. And she was like, oh my God, he's so cute. He taught me how to do this. I found my forever man. Mm-hmm. Until he banged some girl on the bedroom floor and the counter. And I got
shower.
It on video. Shower, all that shit.
Everywhere except for the bedroom, yeah. Did we already get into the chorus and the song, or did we cut it off right there?
Didn't cut it off. So go ahead and go to the chorus. Because
then she follows it up with, and he don't know. And let's find out what he doesn't know.
No, but
what does he not know?
Let's talk about it, and then we'll let her sing it. What does he say? That would
want me
it
to
it?
Like describe?
Yeah,
what
yeah.
She
let's
says.
Go into it, and then we'll let her sing it.
All right. Carrie throws down. I dug my key into the side of his pretty little souped-up four-wheel drive.
Okay, so she just committed a crime.
She vandalized the shit out of his little four-wheeler.
She went deep in it, too. Like, she didn't just put the key on the outside. She went,
dug.
She dented the metal. Like, it's going to be beyond just paint job.
Followed it up with, carved my name into his leather seats, kind of leaving some footprints behind there, girl.
Leaving little evidence. Yeah, probably shouldn't have done that. Maybe use somebody else's name, like, next time. Yeah. The girl that he was banging with, and use her name. That, yeah, right. But to use your own name.
Yeah, cops should come out to you. Just,
are you Carrie? We have a photo here of...
There's also footprints on the gasoline that you poured out of the car that walked all the way back to your apartment.
Back to your apartment.
We
kind of
think that that's a sign. Then she took a Louisville Slugger to both headlights, slashed a hole in all four tires. This
go
girl
back,
is
go back. She had a specific shit. Type of bat, of which yeah. I used to use when I was in T-ball and Little League, and I was like, I need a Louisville Slugger, as well as our boy J-Lo used to call the Bleezies back in college Louisville Sluggers, which, by the way, we don't smoke. Just want to make sure you guys know that. But
this is like
shout out to our boy J-Lo.
You're carrying this on for like 8 episodes now that, you know. Oh,
yeah, it's forever. Yeah. It's kind of a part of our lingering thing.
You could have just said Louisville Sluggers have a different connotation for us back now, but, like, you know, it's fine. But it's not the kind of Louisville Sluggers you take into the headlights.
Yeah, that because it would break and you couldn't even – anyway. Yeah, you're right. So Louisville Slugger to both headlights, both of them. She couldn't even just do one. She went to both.
And then slashed a hole in all four tires.
So how come she didn't knock out the back two lights too? She did the two front lights and then got a knife. So she had multiple tools going into
okay,
this situation.
Okay, let's like reel it in real quick. So this girl that can shoot whiskey with the best of them to the point where she scoffs at any girl that can't also happens to have a Louisville Slugger just on hand.
On hand.
She probably names Betsy. I guarantee you she has a name for her Louisville
That's
Slugger.
That's a good name. That's and exactly the name.
Yeah, and her knife also carries a name, I guarantee you. She has just a pocket knife ready to go.
Can't tell you what the name of that is, but yes, it has a name too.
It's Lizzie McGuire. I don't know
Betsy
why.
Betsy and Lizzie McGuire. Yeah, she has them sitting in her back car.
I don't even remember what Lizzie McGuire is. It's just I like having the idea of having a last name to your knife. Like, that's how trusty it is to her. Takes that to all four fucking tires. It's to the point where this thing has so much damage to it that there's no way that this bill is not coming around back to her. Like, if you had just popped
well,
the tires...
Well, the moment she put her fucking name...
And yeah, you...
in the leather seats, I think she, like, self-incriminated herself.
This is a pretty easy open and shut case for your cop. Like,
now,
you're like, hey.
Let's be granted. She has her man on video camera banging on the sofa and the counter and the shower. So, I mean, she has some reason for it. However, I don't think that holds up in court.
Yeah, legally speaking, I don't think that there's a
anything
whole lot
you can do about it.
Like, what, are you going to, like, ask for the payment for the ash streaks to be buffed out of the kitchen counter? Like,
does the shower need to be decontaminated at this point?
When it comes to monetary value based on destroyed items, this guy's got way more of a case than she does. But... You know, sometimes you get these judges.
He's
that
got
are
a
like,
souped up 4x4. That's what, if you're thinking about it in 21, this is made in what, 2005?
2006.
Okay, yeah. 2006. So let's take it back to those prices. That's probably a $30,000 car.
Mm-hmm.
Minimum. Now it's about a 45.
And if it's souped up, you know, you take it to the shop, that those numbers
it's
that they're going to run
those
there.
Those tires are more expensive.
Oh,
each
it's
one
probably
of those,
more than the value
those
of the
those are $500
car.
Tires at minimum. Yeah. At minimum $500 tires. And all right. Then. Can we go ahead and put the dent in the car with the key in the...
They're going to have to redo the entire side paneling, all the tires, the inside. They're going to have to redo the entire interior.
And let's not forget the two Louisville slugged out headlights.
Yeah, wow.
My goodness.
All right, let's listen to Captain Destructo tell it.
Yeah, listen to her say it. She says it much better than us, but we just put it in perspective. But yeah, Carrie, tell us what you did again.
Do your damage.
I dug my key into the side of this room.
Quick, how did she get in the car? Did she have a key to the car? Like, she carved it in the leather seat. She had to, like, break in the windows.
What if she bashed in the window and she just left that part out? She does have a Louisville Slugger that she's not
she
afraid
probably,
to swing for
she
the fences.
Definitely, that means she had to go through, like, broken glass to write her name in the seat. She's bleeding
She's
as well.
Bleeding everywhere.
This is crazy.
Leaving her DNA all over the site on top of her name in the damn leather seats. All right.
Let's keep it going.
I took a Louisville Slugger to both headlights. Slashed our home and all four tires. Maybe next time.
I think he'll definitely think before he cheats next time.
Here's my question. Is she referring to just cheats in general, or is she saying before he cheats on me?
Oh, she stayed with him?
That's what I'm wondering, because it's like, what kind of fucking psychotic, toxic-ass relationship is if that's just like her retaliation, like, boy, better think again before he tries to cheat on me, I'll tell you what.
And I don't care that he has to pay for the tires and stuff. We're still going to dinner next week. We got a meeting with the family. And, yeah, I hear you, dude. That's crazy. She's crazy talking. Like, she'd beat his car up, and then it's like, but I made dinner. It'll be ready at 5, like, tonight.
Mm-hmm. This is just Wednesday for this couple.
In no way in the song does she ever say she, like, broke up
with
him.
She's done with him, right. Yeah.
She just said, oh, you cheated on me? Bah, 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 bah,
bah. That's how I respond to that.
I'll see you at 6.
You better call me an Uber, because I don't think that souped-up four-wheeler's getting anywhere with them four holes in them tires. Yeah, I heard.
Why are we thinking so country about this? What if this is like a...
Because this country is shit.
Yeah, but what if it's not? What if it's like a, you know, Wisconsin? Like, I can't even do a Wisconsin one.
Hey, that's why, yeah.
Country's way easier to mimic. You're right.
What if this is the kind of girl that then next week or even tomorrow posts, like, pictures of, like, her boyfriend, like, oh, my God, spending Sunday with the love of my life.
Wait, you're going with the route of, like, they didn't actually break up?
Yeah.
They're, but like, they just stayed, like, together through all this?
Obviously, like, after this happened, like, 4 days straight, she was, like, posting shit on her stories and, like, script or, like, a written note that's just, like, you know what? I just think it's funny that some people would rather hang out with bleach blonde girls who drink some fruity-ass drinks and, like, putting her fucking shit out there. She's going to make a song about it.
Or the random inspirational quotes that go, like, you know what? The future is in your eyes.
Don't trust
people. And therefore,
people.
You must rise, or some, like, you know, bullshit.
Don't put your life's worth in the hands of people who don't cherish yours, or some like that.
And then 3 days later.
And then, this is my man. I love him so much. Yeah. No, that's where this is going, I feel like.
Because you know, you're right, Castle. In no way throughout the entirety of the song, they say they actually broke up. She's just saying. And then she's saying before he cheats again. Like, she's going to stay with him.
Better think before he's going to cheat.
Cheats again, because next time I'm going to get his man cave, and all four of those TVs are going to be destroyed. Like, I'm going to smash up that Louisville Slugger I mentioned earlier. Think of the damage.
I'll kabosh that 72-inch plasma he got hanging up in that man cave. You better look out real quick, I'm telling you what.
And that pool table? Mm-mm-mm.
That he's been teaching that floozy how to hit a four-hit combo.
Yeah, that's why he's so good at it, because of that. You know what? That Louisville slug can go right through that. Yeah, exactly. Dude, they never say that she actually
broke up. Let's let her keep telling the story.
Yeah, so. I hope you broke up with him, because if you caught him on
maybe
the bathroom
it's in
floor
this maybe it's
and
in this
videotaped him, and then you put all this shit to his car, and then you still had dinner ready for him when he came home from work on Monday, I don't even know what to say.
Let's hear what she got to say.
Let's hear it.
She's probably up singing some white trash version of Shania karaoke. Right now, she's probably saying I'm drunk, and he's thinking that he's gonna get lucky. Right now, he's probably dabbing on $3 worth of that bathroom hole.
They never broke up.
But she keeps on fantasizing about what she imagines he or she is doing. Actually, you know what? She keeps referring to what she's doing instead of him, which is a weird, like, mental gymnastics mind fuck for her to do.
In what way?
She's more focused on her, whoever the she is. She never really sings about what the guy's doing.
Yeah, she's worried about the fruity drink that the girl's
which
getting.
Also
the karaoke song the girl's drinking.
The bleach
the
hair and stuff,
that the girl has.
It really almost kind of shows that she's fearing her anger at the girl instead of the boyfriend, which also then goes to, like, they probably are still together and shit. Yeah.
They're definitely together.
So, here's what she says. Right now, she's probably up singing some white trash version of Shania karaoke, which... I gotta stop right there because, you know, as being a karaoke DJ, girls absolutely fucking love this song on karaoke.
Dude, this song is a guarantee every single Wednesday.
Love to do this song.
Every single Wednesday at the Canyon Inn, Yorba Linda, 9 to 1, come on down. There is going to be a girl that sings this song. Mm-hmm. Don't know who it's going to be. And you know what happens? Is one girl sings it earlier in the night, another girl wants to sing it later, and I have to tell them, you know, somebody already sang that song, and you know what
they
the girls say?
Fuck.
They're like, Okay, but I want to sing it.
Jen's going to sing it like me. And that's the thing is, like, when they sing this, whenever girls get into this song, I always feel like there's this, like, women empowerment that goes on. I promise there's a handful of girls that are, as they're listening to this right now, are thinking, yes, queen, you tell them, sis. That's right. You stand up for yourself. And I just got to say, is this the role model that we want to use to, like, paint how to handle the situation? You know what? Maybe instead of worrying about, like, taking Louisville Slugger to his headlights and writing your name in the fucking letter, maybe just get the fuck out.
Get out.
Get out of the fucking relationship. You saw him banging on the bathroom floor and the counter and the shower and all this. Clearly, this is not a guy that you're meant to build a life with. So maybe instead of retaliating with taking Betsy the Louisville Slugger to his headlights.
And Lizzie McGuire the knife, the handy-nandy knife.
To the inside and outside interior and ending up with you holding a slate of numbers with mascara running down your face, blood coming down your lip, with an orange jumpsuit. It's going to be a bad look. And not going to be a good.
And it seems like, from what you're saying at this point, you had dinner ready for him the next day. No way do you guys talk about the fact that you guys ended this relationship. You're still with him. Are you okay?
Let's keep it rolling with what she's saying now. Right now, she's probably saying, I'm drunk, and she's thinking that she's gonna get lucky, or he's thinking he's gonna get lucky. Again, still focusing on what the girl's doing. And saying something as basic as I'm drunk now is like, she's she's real. Oh man, I'm just saying, like, from an outsider perspective, a lot of insecurities coming out.
Person.
A lot of insecurity. And it just, like, shows, like,
care about the whoever you're with's person that's doing that. Yes, they had a part of it, but really it was the decision of your significant other.
And she's just painting this picture of, like, what she, like, she's building all this up in her head.
And let's not forget, you caught him on the bedroom floor, on the counter, on the shower.
In our weird Dissect DJ world, we created that.
Holy shit, what is wrong with you?
Then she...
Egregious, this whole thing is.
Finally does actually focus on him a little bit by saying, right now, he's probably dabbing on $3 worth of that bathroom polo, which I think is a cologne. Sounds like some cheap, douchey-smelling cologne.
I can't think of anything else it would be. So
Now she's like...
Which, by the way, she probably thought that cologne was her favorite cologne. She used to smell it and be like, I love that polo.
And now it's like, oh, it's $3 worth of... Yeah. Yeah, exactly. This guy is way up in your head, okay? He's got full control. He's steering that thing like a damn pilot trying to land on the Hudson River right now. This guy is solely in your brain, okay? Yeah. He's got full-on control, and she is focusing all the negative energy against whoever this random floozy that is, like, a faceless, unnamed girl.
Brittany.
That she doesn't even know, that she's going to start calling Brittany, and his four-wheel ride. That's where she's focusing all of her aggression out on. And... yeah, you know what? I gotta say, a lot of girls like to think of this as, like, a female empowerment song. I just hear a lot of insecurity in this. This is just loads and loads of just toxic energy that is focused at the wrong things and not actually doing anything that's actually gonna better who you are or, like, your situation. You
Brittany
know?
Smith.
You just added a last name on it?
Yeah, Brittany Smith.
Okay, you're also focused on the wrong things. That's what I was going to say Shania roll it back. You think she threw Shania in there as the karaoke to, like, kind of throw shade at Shania? Like,
absolutely.
Oh, is this like some little, like...
Like, Shania, you were the 90s chick. You know what? You're old karaoke now, girl.
Man, dude, I got to say...
You know what, Carrie?
Carrie Underwood
is very throwing people under the fucking bus is what she does. It should be Carrie Underbus.
Well, I only really knew Carrie Underwood as the girl who sings the intro to Sunday Night Football, and I always liked her. And I thought she's like...
No, but apparently she's...
This song is
with a
cheating
ex, hates on the other girl, hates on Shania Twain for being a 90s chicken, and she's just karaoke. Fuck you, Carrie!
She's just throwing a lot... There's a lot of insecurities oozing out of this whole song.
All right, let's let her finish this up and tell us the rest of the story, because at this point, I don't like you. I might have said a little trouble for the next girl... Cause the next time that he cheats, oh, you know it won't be on me. Okay, so they broke up.
Okay. That's the first, but it took to, like, what, like, bridge three to, like, finally say that, like, yeah, it's not going to be on me, but.
Yeah, it took it. She's still on him.
Yeah, he's still driving around in your brain like a damn
racetrack. I don't know if he's driving at this point. No, those fucking tires.
He's Ubering. No, not
on me. Which, by the way, when people do this for karaoke, Stop doing this for karaoke, okay, guys? Really? I'll bring a little more vocal art.
Vocal jazz?
Something. Sing a little bit.
Oz, is this
all you guys do is go, hello, karaoke! Like, you gotta get the karaoke, and she don't know.
What do you think they just like?
Like, just stop being so bland with it. Just because it's about a guy or girl beating the shit out of a guy's car, like, still gotta bring some musical etiquette to the song, okay? Stop just, trust me, I've done karaoke right. for multiple years now. Every time you guys fucking sing this damn song, you sing it bland, and you sound like you're just yelling at the guy that somebody cheated on you, and that's all you're doing. Sing the fucking song.
Do you think girls who have been cheated on like this song more or less?
This is their anthem. This is their anthem.
This is where they like pull all their strength from. They're like,
this is their oh my god, I should have put a Louisville sucker, because nobody ever actually does that. Mm-hmm. If you ever get the girl that actually does that, that girl's next level crazy and ready for a lawsuit and ready for it, because you can't give a
fuck if she especially spends 3 to 4 in a penitentiary.
If you put your name, like, you're just
no
say something, motherfucker. Like, she should have just put the car on fire, and then it would have been even better at that point. Like, she left her name and left the situation.
No, this is definitely one of those headlines you see in like the UK Daily Mail, which is like some kind of crazy domestic dispute turns into a fucking insane, like, girl writes her entire name and the guy he cheated on's with name in the side of his Corvette, you know, like, and it just carved as like a picture of it, and you're like, wow. That girl got, like, artistic with her Betsy-ass key.
And then made a plane advertisement and flew it across the beach so that he can see it while he was late into some next level shit. All right, Carrie.
Close us out.
Could I just say something? If he's fully insured, this did nothing. This did. This is him 2 weeks without his truck, and then he'll get it back with brand new tires, brand new paint job, brand new headlights, and a new leather interior car, and just move right along. And I guarantee if he has a souped up 4-wheel drive, he's fully insured. State Farm.
And she's probably ending up in jail. Like,
yeah, just the worst possible situation. Yeah, he just fucked up with you. He was banging on the counter. He was banging in the shower. He was banging on the floor. And you caught him on camera and decided to fucking destroy his car. Got you on fucking your name on there, so he was able to get you. Some people saw you. You go to jail, and his car in 2 weeks is completely the same, if not better, than what it was before you fucked up his car with your Louisville slugger.
Right. If you want to be vindictive, you know, be smarter than this. Do some shit that'll, like, embarrass him, you know? Post some shit, I don't know, that, like, you don't even do that. Really, just be like, you know, take the higher road and just realize this guy sucks and he was obviously terrible for you, and move along, and then realize how happy you are the second that you are onto something else, or just, like, you know, feeling your own independence. Like, that's how you really attain independence. The fact that you're actually spending so much energy and risking yourself ending up in jail just to fucking show it to this guy and then sing a whole song about the potential girl that he may or may not be with right now, like, I don't know, man.
I gotta be honest. I liked your initial approach. Be vindictive. Go there. Go, like, on the internet and, like, and expose him. But do it through somebody else's Facebook that's, like, some other name. That way you don't get caught. But, don't self-incriminate yourself because of how disrespected you are. Like, don't hurt yourself after you just got hurt. That's all I gotta say.
Once you're carving your name,
either leave the situation or do what you're gonna do. Just don't hurt yourself more by doing it.
Yeah. Because now you've been cheated on and you ended up in jail as a result.
Yeah, and now you have a criminal record.
You have a criminal record. You have your name straight up carved, and you end up at an article on the Daily Mail website, you know, and, like, with your fucking headshot as, like, the first picture. And that's when people Google your name now. That's the first thing that's going to pop up.
Again, the mascara crying because you were crying while you destroyed a car, and then he caught you right after because you wrote your name on the leather seat. Did you do your full name too? Like, if you just did your first name, maybe. She never says if she does
with
both
his
name.
With his last name.
Yeah. Dedicated to. Like, Carrie Underwood dedicated to.
It's,
like,
it's Carrie Johnson, and his name is Johnson.
And doesn't use any, like gloves, so her handprints are just all over really the board. And just... Well, I mean, because anybody else could have put the name in there if you think about it. But if she has her handprints all over the board, now you're just...
Here is some blanket advice I would like to give to everybody, just to try to follow if you can, all right? Never let yourself partake in any activity that could result in the top picture of the Google image search when you type in your name be a headshot.
That's good advice.
Whatever you're going to do, whatever wrongful actions have been done against you when you feel vindictive and you want to like get back at somebody, just remember, could the result of this end up being in a story that has my image with a mugshot that's going to be the first thing that I'm looked up at, and that's all everybody's going to think.
I got to be honest, that's great advice. Mm-hmm. It's right up there with Jimmy Dugan's avoid the clap.
That's not the only thing he signed up at baseball. That was a...
League of Their Own reference. Which did we dissect that one? Have you guys?
No, we haven't done it yet. It's been on the list. I thought we were gonna do that one. I know we
because fucking she definitely let go of the ball for her sister.
Yeah,
like, there's no chance. She was a piece of character. Anyways, League of Their Own. Look at the three things.
Did Dottie hold on to the baseball or drop it on purpose, or did she
dropped it on purpose because her sister was lame and she wanted to give her sister a little bit. Plus, she was married. She was gonna go back to her husband.
She didn't give a fuck. Yeah,
yeah, she was over it. She was like, all right.
It's actually a poor decision on Jimmy Dugan's part to give her the starting role.
The other catcher was doing fine. They were ready. Game seven.
He's been playing six games, doing pretty well. Yeah.
Let's get out of that.
That's
but
a
yes.
whole episode. I don't know how Carrie Underwood episode turned into a discussion of
League of Their Own. That's what Dissect DJs did. We go all over the board. But let's bring it back. You caught him on the floor. You then destroyed his car. And now you're in jail. And did you need to do that?
So here's the thing.
Don't think so.
When we ended on Shaggy, we were like, Rick Rock, you piece of absolute shit. Like, we were shitting all over him, as we should have been, because after going through that whole song, you're like, dude, you are a shitty husband and boyfriend, whatever the fuck you are. You shouldn't be any of that, because you're a...
Yeah.
Yeah, you're...
He even tried to tell her at the end, I'm sorry for the things that I've done, even though he really didn't care.
No, he only got to the very end of the song. He was like, I want to tell her I'm sorry. He didn't even tell her.
Yeah, he just...
like, says that late in the song. Yeah.
But yeah, so...
But then I was like, there's no way that the response of it could actually have me thinking the other person is down around that same level that Rick Rock was.
You were wrong, sir.
Now I'm looking at this... So we should check in on Carrie Underwood, because I don't really know much about her, but after going through this, like, this exposed a lot of insecurities that are going around in this girl's brain, and I just feel like if you're a girl that likes to jam to this song, and this is your shit, and you want to sing it in karaoke, if it's a musical acumen that you like about it, fair play. But if it's really the lyrics that get you off...
Because of the deepness of something that happened to you?
Mm-hmm. I'm just saying, take a step back and evaluate what's important to you and how you should react. Like, it's not to say that this is something that you would do, but if you get excited, a little too excited about listening to this song, it's self-evaluation, I think. A little key. That's crucial. Absolutely. Okay. Let's slap this out, all right? Justin. I was almost going to say Shania Twain. Carrie would have hated if I said that. You know what?
She would have heard it, and Shania would have been so happy.
She would have brought Betsy and Lizzie
McGuire. I bet these two hate each other. I want to see them in an episode of Celebrity Deathmatch. Carrie Underwood versus
solid 2001 reference right there.
Get that? All right. Same area where the song came out.
Yeah, good. A little bit.
All right, here we go. It goes. Tired of fucking people doing this song every fucking week. That's really more my reason for it. The song is cool. It's actually a cool rebuttal because, in all honesty, if you step back, I know we're trying to be all politically correct, but if a girl saw her man banging on the counter, banging on the shower, banging on the bedroom floor, she got him on camera. You know what? A little retaliation is necessary, and she beat the fuck out of his car. Now, we already said he has insurance. He gets it back in 2 weeks. Kind of a pointless thing, and now you're in jail. But still, some type of retaliation was needed. Could have went better. Could have went a different route. She beat the fuck out of this guy's car. That's all she really did, really, actually, if you think about it. Before he cheats, he's going to get his car fucked up. That's it. There's nothing really else he talks about.
No, she talks all about the potential girl that may or may not exist.
Yeah, the girl, and then how much he fucks up his car. But it's like nothing else. She could have went way deeper.
There could have been a third verse where, like, she talked about, like, the emotional aspect of it.
But no, she just hated his car.
Never really even got into that. Yeah, never got into, like, what this relationship even really meant to her or what him doing that has done to her or, like, how she feels about it.
Again, if he has Geico or Survival...
No, the car has actually probably had enough damage to it where it might even be referred to as total, and he actually just gets like
a whole new fucking truck plus that wheels. Like, yeah, plus that one. He has two cars now. Mm-hmm. He just puts some new wheels. That's his used car, and now he has a brand new. Yeah, I don't know. Probably could have came up with some better ideas, but retaliation was necessary, and she did that. And but the song just replayed over and over, and ladies just keep doing it. And I swear to you, Castle, I have seen ladies hear it earlier in the night and think they can do it better than that girl, so they ask to do it an hour later. I'm like, nobody wants to fucking hear that song twice in a night. Please. Just come back next week and try it that week.
Here's my thinking to that. If it's the kind of girl that would really love the song because of the lyrics, it's probably the same kind of girl that would be like, fuck that girl, I'll do it better than her.
Same girl.
Oh, was she a bleach blonde floozy who likes a fruity drink with a tramp stamp and listens to some Shania karaoke? And you're like, no, she was doing the karaoke.
Her name was actually Carrie Underwood. Guadalupe. She was
doing Carrie Underwood, literally the same song that you're trying to do for karaoke.
Colombian,
now.
Actually. So she just.
You guys have the same taste in, you know, vindictive music.
Yeah. You guys, okay. You guys should be friends. Actually, she's right over there. You guys take a shot of whiskey together. Or
I think I've seen y'all leave here with the same guy too. So you guys can talk about that and then act like you're best friends, but actually secretly hate each other.
Yeah. We've seen it before. Yeah. It's the story that's timeless.
A tale as old as time. All right.
What are you slapping, snapping? Okay.
It was a Louisville slugger.
A slap, a snap, and a Louisville slugger. Okay, I like it.
All right, so I would give this a couple slaps because it is a catchy tune. I don't get as annoyed with it as girls doing it all the time because I don't do the karaoke DJing like you do. So no, you're a little bit more worn out. I have seen girls perform this that, like, it brings out a certain sexiness in some girls, like when they kind
of
perform it.
And some of them cry during it.
Okay, well, that's
just...
not the ones I'm talking about. I have seen girls perform this where it's like, all right, yeah, go get it. All right, you're bringing the A game to the stage. I like that. So it's decent song. I would give it a couple slaps for that. I'd take it down a slap, however, because it's just a terrible form of retaliation that I don't think should be glorified as much as girls like to glorify it. But the snap is for the girls who actually can perform it to the best ability. And then the Louisville Slugger is just because...
What a fantastic reference, right? Yeah. It brings me back to my little major league 12-year-old self.
Saw got a lot of good memories with Louisville
Target.
Sluggers.
I was like, I want one of those.
The one was with a big, huge barrel.
Yeah, exactly.
I was all about the fat barrels. I remember having a bat that was, like, way too heavy, but, like, I didn't want to admit it to myself. And I was like, no, it's my bat. It's got a huge fucking... I'm gonna get a hold of one of these balls one of these days,
that's
and it's going
to
be all worth it.
I had the complete opposite. I had the smallest bat possible. Just because I like to whip it around as fast as possible. I had to just whip it around. No power behind it, just whip it around.
Hey, Tony Gwynn, one of the greatest hitters of all time, he apparently played with a 28-inch bat, which is, like, Little League style. But he just knew how to get a bat on that ball at all times. So, it was like, he could hit it wherever he wanted to.
It's crazy.
But, it would literally, like, go to his head. It was crazy looking. But, yeah, no, I've had great members of Louisville Slugger. So, the Louisville Slugger reference alone gets a Louisville Slugger. But, yeah, that's kind of where I stand on that. Yeah. So there we go. We did some country for y'all.
And we mixed
country
it with it wasn't me. You see what she retaliated.
It didn't really mix
and we
it
honestly have found out that she didn't retaliate correctly. Like, there's so many different ways you could have. But
it's poor mindset,
that's
girls.
What she did. And all you ladies love her because of it. So it is what it is. Well,
but you shouldn't, you know?
Yeah.
This isn't the best path to be a better you. But you know what? Whatever gets you through a Wednesday. I don't know.
Hey, when you're done with that guy, you know what it's time to do? It's time to move on to the
next